So, Cliff, this past week also saw it's something that's really sort of sad in terms of what the union tradition has been in Wisconsin, and that is Scott Walker, who is one of two basically front runners in the Republican primaries, to the extent that there is one yet, has yet to start. One of the two Republican front runners signed into law a so-called right to work, which really ultimately is basically a right to work with depressed wages law in Wisconsin. And just so that people understand, because I've seen this reported, frankly, incorrectly, but right. What a so-called right to work legislation does. As you know, Cliff, there are if a shop votes or a business votes to unionize with a majority of people who are working there vote to unionize after there is more than enough time for the company to basically dissuade people from that by hook or crook. if you decide, yeah, exactly, and if you decide to not become a member of the union still becomes the primary agent to negotiate your contract. And there's something called agency fees or fair share fees, which are basically a payment that is not necessarily the size of the union dues, where it pays for the union to provide those services of negotiating on your behalf because your fellow workers have voted for it. This basically gets rid of it and creates a free rider problem. Why would you pay those? Why would you pay the union anything if you get their services for free? And so this fundamentally undercuts unions, and that, of course, is the agenda. And now it's law in Wisconsin, joining about 24 other states.
Yeah, I mean that's exactly right. It was tough first seeing this in sort of such a union state as Michigan pass, which it did. I think it was last year.
2012, I think it was Michigan and Indiana that were the last states to do this.
Right. So, I mean, and then Wisconsin, it's another blow because, I mean, obviously, when you think of these sort of strongholds, these union strongholds, particularly in the Midwest, that you think of that. And, I mean, yeah, it is amazing. And again, at a time when the economy has started to really improve and, you know, the stock market's doing well, unemployment's going down, jobs are being created, but we still have this issue of wages. We still have companies who are behaving in a different manner than they behaved historically when, you know, we've got record corporate profits. And in the past, a lot of those profits were put into, you know, raising people's wages. Now there's all sorts of other things that those profits are put into, you know, stock buybacks to drive up the stock price and other things to so that these guys keep benefiting. And, you know, in the end, that's hurt wages, and unions are one of the few sort of forces out there that can help bring up, you know, workers' pay. And these guys still think somehow they're living in this libertarian dream where we're not all in this together. At some point, when we're a largely consumer-based economy, you will run out of consumers if they have no money to buy stuff. You know, at some point, the Koch brothers, that terrible toilet paper their company sells, well, people won't be able to buy it anymore. But these guys, you know, they're so obsessed and they're so short-sighted. So, I mean, that's, you know, it is a shame. And it's terrible to happen in Wisconsin. And Scott Walker, of course, you know, who's sort of a poster boy for every bad Republican policy, not to mention, you know, the intellect of Sarah Palin and the consistency on policy of Mitt Romney. Should be an interesting guy, because the more he does, the more he speaks out, the more he signs legislation, everything he does, the more I become convinced that he will be going nowhere.
Well, I want to talk about Walker, the political forces behind this in a second. But the irony is, or perhaps it's not the irony, but a report came out from the International Monetary Fund economists Florence Jamot and Carlina Boutron over the past couple of weeks, showing that the lower rates of workers belonging to unions are strongly associated with more income going to the wealthiest. I mean, this is something that seems quite obvious, but the authors write, we find strong evidence that lower unionization is associated with an increase in top income shares in advanced economies during the period of 1980 to 2010. In particular, They found that the decline in unionization explains about half the rise in incomes for the richest 10%. And half of the increase in the Gini coefficient, which is, of course, a measure of income inequality. It's also associated with less redistribution of income between the best off and the least well off. Now, this makes total sense. And like, as you say, if they're not paying their workers and they have this this money, it simply goes to their shareholders or their board of directors or their top executives in the form of capital gains and whatnot. And so, you know, when we look at this, you mentioned the Koch brothers, but the other thing that I think is impacting on Scott Walker, because you're right, he did flip flop on this. He had said this was not about right to work when he attacked the public sector unions 3 or 4 years ago.
Yep.
Now,
kind of like his abortion rights position, his foreign policy positions. There've been a lot of flip flops from this guy, but I will let you continue.
Well, remember, right? There are two massive players in terms of money. I mean, there's a lot more, but there are two massive ones who have shown an inclination to burn money just to impact the primaries. And we're talking about Sheldon Adelson, the gambling mogul, who is under investigation because of some of his business
bribery
practices.
In Macau and parts of China, I believe, if I'm correct.
Indeed. And the Koch brothers, who have said they're going to put in basically $1 billion into funding Republican elections over the coming years. Well, Scott Walker is a darling to both. And you remember what's on Sheldon Adelson's wish list? It's basically he wants to nuke everybody around Israel. And then he
nuke every union if you want to stay consistent, which may be why Scott Walker compared ISIS to unions.
I'll tell you something.
Go ahead.
Well, that could have been something that Sheldon Adelson said to him in some meeting that they had when Adelson talked about the money, right?
Like, yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. Absolutely.
And, you know, so to us, it may sound stupid, but to Scott Walker, it may have just earned him literally millions of dollars for the Republican primary.
Well, and that's a great point, because it says something also about the system that we're working in. That system that the brilliant Anthony Kennedy, I believe, said wouldn't create the appearance of impropriety, and if people weren't coordinating these expenditures, how would, you know, and there wasn't a quid pro quo bribe, how would that pressure people who were in government? Because you could totally not foresee that a bunch of these guys, even if it's an independent expenditure or a gift to a PAC or whatever it might be, would go in front of people like Adelson and kiss his ring and do whatever he says so he can give. Yeah, some money directly to them, but plenty of money to independent organizations or start his own or do whatever to support them. And somehow the brilliant Anthony Kennedy was unable to see that this could happen. And that's our system right now. Not to mention, Scott Walker, I don't know if you saw this, just got the coveted Scott Baio endorsement.
I didn't see that.
Chachi does love Scott Walker, and I think knowing that, we should all be frightened in many ways.
Indeed. And I'm frightened just that you knew that, Cliff.